Oh man, it has been one heck of a lame duck period. A lot less lame and a lot more duck! The question today is, with less than a week left on the shot clock, what does it look like to buzzer shot an impeachment? Furthermore, because Mitch McConnell isn't going to take the Senate out of recess to hear this impeachment trial before inauguration, what does it even look like to host an impeachment trial for a former president? We're taking you out of retirement for one last job. Nah, we just want to fire you. So what does it mean to remove someone who's already left? Well, the first question most of you are probably asking is, why? Is this just kicking the man while he's down? Well, losing this specific trial in the Senate would carry with it two punishments. First, removal from office, that's null, and second, a ban from running for federal office again. If things go right for Democrats, you're either going to need to update that Trump 2024 merch or find a different Trump. So legal consequences for impeaching and removing this ex-president are real. Now this brings us to the larger constitutional question of, can you have an impeachment trial in the Senate against someone who has already left office? The answer is, well, it's up for interpretation. Yep, the Constitution's a bit vague here, not explicitly saying who is subject to the House's impeachment power, or explicitly prohibiting the impeachment of former officers. Alright, so with the Constitution a bit on this one, we need to make like a high school English student and analyze this text for ourselves. What do you think the authors meant when they wrote, "The president, vice president, and all civil officers of the United States shall be removed from office on impeachment for and conviction of treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors." Now, critics of impeaching ex-officials will argue, gee, it certainly seemed like that was written for the purposes of, I don't know, ejecting political leaders from their office before they can do more damage. If this guy's already out of office, well, that kind of defeats the intended purpose of impeachment, truly beating a dead horse. This argument is best illustrated by a recent Washington Post op-ed which says, "The very concept of constitutional impeachment presupposes the impeachment, conviction, and removal of a president who is, at the time of his impeachment, an incumbent in the office from which he is removed. Indeed, that was the purpose of the impeachment power, to remove from office a president or other civil official before he could further harm the nation from the office he then occupied." Now, of course, the other side would look at that and argue, let's put a little more emphasis on that word presupposes. When you're writing laws, nothing goes without saying. And guess what? They didn't say that. They presupposed it. We're really going off Airbud rules on this one. Ain't no law that says we can't impeach the ex-president. Now the process says that the House is the entity that impeaches the president, and the Senate hears all impeachments. Well, the House just impeached a sitting president. The guy's still in office, so no problem there. Now the more specific question is, when the Constitution says that the Senate shall have the sole power to try all impeachments, does that mean all impeachments? All is a pretty strong word. A more focused question for the rest of this episode is, can the Senate hold a trial for a legitimate impeachment request that was made while the president was still in office after the president is out of office during the trial? Impeachment advocates argue that, sure, the Constitution describes the purposes of impeachment as removing a dangerous politician from office, but the founders later specified that judgment in cases of impeachment shall not extend further than to removal from office and disqualification to hold and enjoy any office of honor, trust, or profit under the United States. Now because that word disqualification was just slipped into the punishment column there at the end, they would argue that the real reason for impeachment could also be to remove a dangerous politician from obtaining a future office. While this question has never officially been reviewed by a court, it is the running interpretation in Congress that you can try an ex-official. The Senate proceeded in two cases involving officials who had resigned from office before their trial. Therefore, the congressional understanding of its impeachment power currently includes the possibility of trial of formal officials. That's right, when it comes to elected office, the "you can't fire me, I quit" strategy won't work. The core of this debate today is, did the founders create the impeachment mechanism solely to remove a politician from office, with disqualification being a little cherry on top, or would they accept disqualifying a former politician from holding future offices to be an acceptable driving force for an impeachment case? Or as Lindsey Graham, the head of the Senate Judiciary Committee, put it,
"Under this theory, the radical left, if you can impeach a president after they're out of office, why don't we impeach George Washington? He owned slaves. Where does this stop?"
Thanks for doing the opposite of clearing things up, bud. Yes, let's get together and make sure that George Washington can't run for office again. I think there might be bigger obstacles there, just in case there aren't any sort of advances in necromancy over the next decade. Now there's one final super important piece to this question. Whose job is it to answer the question, can the Senate hold a trial for an ex-president who was impeached while still in office? In the Supreme Court case of Nixon versus United States, different Nixon by the way, Mississippi Chief Justice Walter Nixon was in the process of being impeached and removed. Now the legal fight here doesn't matter. What does matter is, it made it up to the Supreme Court, where the justices threw up their hands and slowly backed away. They wrote, in no uncertain terms, "Parties do not offer evidence of a single word in the history of the Constitutional Convention, or in contemporary commentary, that even alludes to the possibility of judicial review in the context of the impeachment powers." Yeah, the power to impeach politicians is firmly under the Congress Powers section of the Constitution. There is a very real possibility that should it get to that level, the Supreme Court might not even be able to weigh in on this question, meaning that it's really up to the Senate to decide whether the Senate can hear this case. Now the most likely path forward is, this question is going to come up as an objection in the Senate before the trial even begins. At that point, you'd need a simple majority, or 51 senators, to vote to dismiss the claim before proceeding to the trial. If all of that happens, you'd then need that classic 67 senator supermajority to vote against Trump for the Senate to convict the former president, disqualifying him from future office. Of course, I'm not sure if you've noticed, but Trump is not one to shy away from the occasional court battle, no matter what the odds are. So I'd bet my entire life savings that should we get to this point, he'd try and appeal this case to the Supreme Court, on the premise that he was not a sitting president when they convicted him. Now whether or not the Supreme Court case is going to take that or not, well that's an episode for a later date. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Until then, thank you and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I'd like to thank my patrons here for helping me put out my videos. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news looking into the overlooked, join this growing list of exceptional individuals by clicking on that link in the description. Also remember to subscribe and ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring. Give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw, and lastly, as always, thank you for watching.